Hello, Ignite members. Gloria Grace Rand here, and I am with the lovely fellow Ignite member, Laura Earley, who is going to tell us a little bit about herself and where she lives and what her business is, and we'll get to know each other better. So, and then you'll get to learn more about her as well. So welcome, Laura, and yeah, let us know who you are and what you're all about.
Thanks, Gloria, for doing this. I think it's a great way for people to connect. I think, you know, Facebook in general is becoming a very noisy place. And when you can build relationships and connections and know what people do in general, it's a lot more, I think, effective than just, you know, posting and running and having acquaintances. So I appreciate you doing this. Great.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah. I'm having a lot of fun doing it because I really get to, we've got some really interesting people in the group. And so I love learning everything, you know, learning as much as we can about different people and what they're all about. So yeah, tell us a little bit about your business and what brought you here?
Well, I'm always interested in the entrepreneurial journey, A, because I am one, but B, I'm really passionate about helping entrepreneurs. There is a spirit about us. We have a vested interest in helping ourselves and, you know, connecting to our intuition because our business thrives on it. And what I do, I read souls and I read businesses for a living. It's awesome work. So technically I'm a professional psychic, but I also have a psychotherapy background and my specialty is reading energy. So I can really diagnose where people and their businesses are stuck. So you know how, you know, your business is growing and you up level and you get a new marketing campaign and maybe you hire a virtual assistant and, you know, you're upping your sales strategy. So you get a CRM system and then all of a sudden it's like, wait, this isn't working. Like my sales have declined or my revenue. And it's like, wait, but I've added all these things. So my gifts allow me to look at everything that's going on in the business and tell you exactly what's not working and why. And it just saves a whole lot of time rather than willy-nilly guessing and being like, well, I think it's my marketing campaign. So you know what? Let me tweak my copy. But if that's not what the problem is, you're essentially fixing something that isn't broken. So in a nutshell, that's basically what I do for business owners.
That's awesome. Well, is there, have you found that there's like a particular, either industry that you like to work with or a particular type of business owner that, you know, even depending on like how long they've been in business, what have you found has been sort of your sweet spot that you like working with?
You know, I work with a variety of businesses. I like that because it gets a little bit dull for me if I'm just working with the same type of person. But I really want to use what I can do to help a multitude of people. So I have clients who have just started on the entrepreneurial journey and they're getting clarity. And then I'm also working with established business owners that are making six figures that have up-leveled and it like totally did not go how they expected it to. The only requirement that I really have is that someone has to have an established business and to have made a sale. Even if you're just starting out and you just sold like a $99 ebook or something, what it does is it energetically sets up the business. So if it's just like an idea or a plan, that's not really me. They're probably best working with someone who can help them develop a strategy. But then I can help them from there really tweak it so that it soul aligns, so that it aligns with how they operate best. You know, to fix what's not working, to make tweaks. So that's really where my work shines.
Awesome. Well, I was going to ask you, but like what one question I've been asking everybody in the group is kind of like what is their superpower? And I suspect you probably kind of already alluded to it, but maybe what I'll say, ask you instead is how did you come to realize that this is what you're, you know, really good at doing and tapping into your intuition? How did that come about?
Oh boy, divine intervention. Because I was doing traditional psychotherapy, and there is a diagnostic process in traditional therapy as well. You kind of have to figure out what's going on with the person, what the real problem is, because most people come in with symptoms and, you know, the that surface level stuff. But it was taking a really long time to do that. But I was also suppressing myself. As a psychotherapist, I mean, you go through training and you take, you know, state boards, and there is this professionalism that goes with it, and you have credentials. And I always knew that I could do something different, and the traditional psychotherapy was very unfulfilling. But I was a little bit afraid to say, hey, these are my gifts. And it really took the right mentors. I mean, yes, believe it or not, there are mentors and teachers for psychics. You'd be like, oh, who would have thought? But you exist. So I just happened to stumble on the right person. When I was open to letting go and being who I truly was and owning what I could do, because I was really, you know, doing a disservice not using that part of you know, my gifts and skills. When I decided, then all of a sudden the right mentor just fell into my lap, and she really trained me on boundaries and ethics and what information I could find and how to accurately assess it. So it was just me saying, you know what, I'm open, and me being like, okay, I need help. Bring me somebody.
I love it. Yeah. I've been in similar circumstances, and it's been so wonderful when the universe helps you out like that and says, okay, here, will this help? And it's like, oh, yes, thank you.
So you have to be ready for it and actually make a committed decision, because I realized that when I was like, oh, maybe yes, maybe no, and I had like one foot in and one foot out, nothing. Yeah. It was like, where's my help?
That's true. Yeah. You really do have to be ready to take action on it and be fully in on like, this is what I want to do. Okay. How do I make this happen now? And then, and that's key. So that's awesome. So tell me a little bit more about your personal side. So I understand you've got some sort of passions that have kind of led you in a lot of different directions on your life journey so far. So
Well, currently I live in Miami Beach, Florida, with the love of my life and my three cats. That's all the children that I ever wanted was my fur babies. They're enough for me. And, you know, I'm a little bit unique in choices that I make. I think it's really in my quest for fun and excitement and doing something really different. For example, in college, I joined the circus. And it was really to get out of a PE credit because I hated PE. And apparently if you join, this is a thing, this is truly a thing. If you join the circus in college, you got PE credits. Join the circus.
You went to Florida State?
I did.
Yeah, that's what I thought, because that's where my daughter went. So yeah, okay, that's very cool.
Yeah. So I did that. And then I was at a point in my traditional psychotherapy career where I was burned out and unfulfilled. So my husband at the time and I, we ended up taking jobs in a Yupik Eskimo village in the lower Yukon, Alaska. And we worked there for 2 years. There's like no roads. You take a little bush plane. They drop you off and they're like, bye. And you're like, what are you getting yourself into? But you know, it was there that taught me what was important in life and what I could live with and what I could live without. And it was a very life-changing time for me. So I tend to do things like that as a way to say, you know what, this sounds like fun. This is so different. I wonder what's going to happen on the other side of this. So that's just kind of me. I do these like quirky things, and a lot of people are like, oh my God, you're so courageous and adventurous. I don't feel that way for some reason, but other people see it that way.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I think it is a wonderful quality to have, and I'm, you know, you're embracing it and having the insight to be able to say, this is what I need, is really great. Because yeah, I think a lot of people sometimes they have a desire for it, but they're just not, maybe they're too scared to pursue it, or they just don't really, they're not really aware of it. So that's cool that you can do that. So awesome. Yeah. Good for you.
I push myself to travel, to go to new places. I love going internationally. I've been to a lot of different countries. And I think that the more you push yourself, the more in general that you grow. and you learn things about yourself. When you are safe and, you know, don't do things out of fear, that's when you just become stuck and stagnant. And usually that's what I'm telling, you know, people when I work with them. I'm like, okay, this is what you're doing. I'm not going to get you what you want. So this is what you have to do. And they're like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. And it's like, but yeah, you know, this is what needs to happen.
Yeah, absolutely. You got to step out of your comfort zone.
Yeah.
If you want to grow. So that's awesome. Well, thank you so much for being here and sharing a little bit about what you do. And I'm so glad that you're a member of the group. And just a reminder to the rest of you that if you haven't booked an interview, make sure that you do that. There's I'll put the link, I think, in this video again, start doing that. But I know it's at the top of our timeline or whatever they call it in the group. But take advantage of it, because I think it's a good way for everyone to be able to get to know you and see what you're all about. And I love learning this. So I would love to have another chat with you after later on, because there may be a way for us to do some things together, I have a feeling. So I'm glad that you're in the group. And So thanks again, Laura, and we'll catch the rest of you some other time.
Thanks. Bye.